Well, an elegantly busy week for Fox Marble. The Balkans-based marble group raised £2 million to cover the cost of kitting out a new factory in Kosovo and training the staff. Well, today, news that the order book has increased to $3.9 million for the year. Well, for more details, we are joined by the Chief Executive, Chris Gilbert. So, Chris, it is all coming together. You did tell investors in January that you expected an acceleration in order intake, but have you now surpassed the target that you set at the beginning of the year?
Hello, Sarah. I'm not sure that's the case, but we're in May now, and we're pleased with the progress that we've made. So we've got an order book that's expanding in the line with our forecasts and the way we suggest this is going to go. And by the end of the year, we expect to be where we said we would be some time ago.
Okay.
So that's encouraging.
So you've got four quarries. You've produced nine varieties of stone, including the Malsheva, the milk white marble in central Kosovo, which I know a lot about. So the factory is the next logical step, isn't it? So that the chunks can be presented as the cut and polished slabs.
Yes, the key milestone here is the factory, which people have been waiting a long time for, rather longer than we said they would have to wait. So for that, we're sorry. The factory does several things for us. The first thing that it does is it improves the yields in the quarry, because it means we can process types of blocks and stone that would be uneconomic to send to where we process at the moment in Italy and in Greece. Also, obviously, it improves our margins because we're not paying away a margin to a third-party processor. The other thing it does is it gives us flexibility and a better ability to service our supply chain. And the key component domestically is it gives us access to the domestic market. And that's a very big market, and it'll give us a customer base that we currently don't have.
So are you now a one-stop shop? And if so, surely this is very attractive to existing and potential customers for the reasons that you've just outlined.
We are a one-stop shop. We're vertically integrated all the way through to where our customer interface is. Having said that, our customer base is not the retail community. It's not your kitchen and bathroom or my kitchen and bathroom. We're a volume architectural materials supplier to distributors, developers, designers, architects. And, these are big orders that we're now currently winning. And as we announced this morning, we're also still selling block marble. And one of the orders that we announced this morning was to a Greek customer who's taking thousands of tons of our low-grade white civet between, and it's a €500,000 order between now and the end of the year. So we're continuing that side as well.
And do you have many customers of that calibre within the pipeline, or are you in negotiations? Anything you can tell us?
Nothing I can tell you, Sarah, but obviously it's an ongoing process. And one of the things that we're encouraged by is the number of people that are visiting our quarries now, potential customers that are coming to see our civet quarry, which of course is a much in-demand marble. And we're finding that the Illyric White that you've just mentioned, that we've just opened, people are responding very well to it at all levels.
So you're having more customers. I'm wondering if the next logical step is to have another quarry. Are you sort of looking for potential sites?
We're always looking for potential sites. And we've got sites within our orbit that we're aware of and we're sort of familiar with. We need to stick to our knitting for the rest of this year and deliver on the forecasts, and that's we're working very hard on for the time being.
Okay, so it's all about integration. Now, in terms of that £2 million that you raised,
yes.
What kind of support did you have? Were you overwhelmed?
We were, in the end, oversubscribed, which was a shock or a surprise, a pleasant surprise. We were largely supported by our existing group of shareholders. We're privileged to have these shareholders who have been with us from day one or nearly day one, and they've stuck with us. And I think they can understand now, that the plan is, as you say, coming together, and that slightly delayed, but nevertheless, everybody can see that the factory commissioning is in sight and that our order book is growing. And I think that's where the level of support came from.
So in terms of potential shareholders, looking at where the share price is now, does it reflect opportunity, growth and that integration that we've been discussing?
Well, like every CEO in the world, I think my company is undervalued, and our share price is certainly low historically to where it has been. which I think is a fair reflection of people's attitude towards the delays that they've experienced in seeing this coming together. But we think there's a big opportunity here. There is.
Okay, so we've talked a lot about the customers that you have and have just recently come on board. In terms of distribution, we know you have a good relationship with distributor Eboricum.
Eboricum. Yes.
Now, is this an exclusive relationship, or are there more distribution partnerships required to assist with the developmental pipeline you've got?
None of our relationships are exclusive. We don't grant exclusivity anywhere at the moment. But what we do is that we play fair with our distributors. So Eboricum focused very much on the north of this country. Pisani happened to be, well, they're based in London and it's, you know, within the M25 and to the south, and some of their international customers. And that we will build out over the rest of the country and then throughout the rest of Europe and obviously further afield into North America and the Far East. And there'll be similar types of relationships.
So finally, in terms of this knitting, that you have to sit down and do your knitting, what are the milestones that we should be expecting over the next 6 months? Or is it purely focusing on the factory and training up the staff?
I think the three things that we have to do is as we talked about, we need to get to where we said we would get to with respect to our anticipated forecasts and turnover by the end of the year. So that's marketing, sales and distribution. So that's the big focus. And the third part of that is the building out of this platform internationally, particularly in North America and the Far East. And that's the knitting we're sticking to.
Lovely. Chris Gilbert, Chief Executive of Fox Marble. Thank you very much indeed for joining us today.
Sarah, thank you.